Hello everyone. Now we will see the concept of key management. Key management is basically the management of cryptographic keys in the crypto system. It basically includes dealing with the generation of the keys, exchanging the keys, storage of the keys, use and replacement of the keys. Now we will see the concept of symmetric key distribution center, or simply we call it as KDC. The key distribution center, or KDC, provides a practical solution where we are using a trusted third party, which is going to reduce the number of keys between sender and the receiver. Now let us see the process in which the sender can send confidential message to the receiver. So it will be like this. The sender, or the person like Alice, is sending request to the KDC, that is key distribution center, stating that she need a session secret key between herself and Bob. Bob is the receiver. Then the KDC is going to inform Bob, or the receiver, about the sender's request. If the receiver is agreeing, then a session key is created between the two people so that they can exchange the message. Now let us see the different type of KDCs. First one is flat multiple KDC. Here, when the number of people using the KDC increases, it is becoming very unmanageable. To solve this kind of problem, we can divide the entire world into the different domains, as you can see here in this small diagram, wherein the sender is going to send the message through the KDCs. Now here you can see there are different KDCs, KDC1, KDC2 and KDCN. So through this different KDCs, he or she is going to send the message to the receiver. Okay, so here as an example, I have taken, if the sender is in one domain and the receiver is in another domain, then the sender can contact her KDC, which in turn contacts to the KDC of the receiver in the receiver's domain. Now, both these KDCs can create the secret key between the sender and the receiver. And this type of system, we call it as flat multiple KDC. Now, let us see the different type of, the other type of KDC. The other type of KDC is hierarchy multiple KDC. The first one was flat multiple KDC. Now, hierarchy multiple KDC. This system is having one or more KDCs arranged in the form of hierarchy. As you can see in this diagram, we are having different KDCs. Like the sender is having their own local KDC. This local KDC is connected to the national KDCs. And these national KDCs are connected to the international KDC. So at the top, we are having international KDC. Again, at the receiver side, we are having national KDCs and local KDCs of the receiver. The concept of hierarchy multiple KDC is like this. If the sender and receiver are in different countries, imagine this is different country and this is different country. And if the sender, Alice, wanted to communicate or send certain message to the Bob, who is in the other country, then the Alice is going to send the request to her local KDC. And this local KDC relays the request to the national KDC, which forwards the request to the international KDC. The request is then relayed all the way down to the local KDC of the receiver called Bob. This is the way in which they can establish the key so that they can send or receive the message. Then now let us see, as we know, by using the different KDC, we are going to create the session key. Now, what exactly is this session key? Let us see. If a KDC is creating a secret key for each member, this secret key can be used between the members and the KDC, but not between two different members. Okay. And this kind of keys can be used only once between the parties so that they can communicate. If we see the different ways which we can utilize to create session keys, then we can have simple protocol using KDC, Needham's Corder protocol, and Otway Reese protocol. You can go through this different kind of session key methods by using which we can create the session keys. Thank you.